Hi there, everyone. This time, we'll talk about one of the very, very fascinating techniques while you work with shapes or text boxes or charts or tables. That is cloning these objects. What is cloning these objects? In simple term, it means Control C and Control V. But I would want that you see something new, open your mind to a completely different trick, which will make the Control C and the Control V sound obsolete. Correct. Let me show you some examples before I begin talking about this trick. This is one of the screenshots taken from a UN development report available publicly online. And one of the pages, I see very nice illustration of how the different shapes have been placed. In fact, the distances between these shapes, you notice it's absolutely symmetrical. So you'll see one of the many tricks that will help you make this fast, accurate. We'll go about it. But let me show you one more example. And this is from the same report, from the UN development report, as I said, publicly available. You can go through the website and search for it. Even here, you'll notice all the different shapes of same sizes, you know, being put aside adjacent to each other. In fact, I have taken another example from Bain & Company's publicly available report. I've given a source at the footer, the bottom. It's a global diamond report, which was released in 2013. And I notice that one of the illustrations talking about the supply chain has so many similar looking shapes. And if I wish to put this into slide, what are the different techniques that can help me make this fast? So let me now discuss about that trick. So let me go to the next slide, which is a blank slide. It's been kept so that we can practice. Normally, whenever you create a shape, let's say a rectangle, and if you want to create, let's say, three blocks below each of these, then Control C and Control V, that is the one that people make use of, right? Okay. Some people might also use the shortcut key of duplicate, that is Control D, straight away Control D. So basically, it's saving you one shortcut key less, Control C, that is. Now, what I want to discuss is something beyond this. Let's say I have a rectangle. I am going to press the Control key from the keyboard, and notice there's a small plus sign like icon coming up on your screen on the cursor side. At that point in time, I'm going to use the mouse, the left click, and just drag it out. Notice a replica has been created. In fact, if I hold both of these together and then drag it out by pressing Control key, it's held together. But this is not so cool. You know what is cool? If you press Control and Shift, both of them together, and keep it pressed, do not release that Shift Control until I say so. With that, from the other side of the laptop, from the mouse, I'm using the left click of the mouse and then dragging it down. Notice, it is in alignment. They are following one common middle line. In fact, if I choose all the three and then Shift Control right, notice 9 blocks easily made. Now, of course, I know that some of you who are not using the mouse and using the laptop, you might face little trouble, because if you keep Shift Control pressed with these two keys, your thumb should be on the left click of the keypad. That's how the first step is going to happen. The two fingers on the Shift and Control, the thumb on the left click of the keypad, and then the sensitive touchpad you use to just drag it out. Try this. On the other hand, some of you might also ask me that, look, the distances between these shapes are not equal. Well, let me tell you that this is just one of the tricks to help you. There are other tricks like alignment, which will help you get the desired result. So we'll come to that a little later. Right now, our focus is on using Shift and Control to make replicas of the same object. When I say object, I not only refer to shape, I refer to text boxes, table and charts and pictures. So in fact, notice this particular illustrations, I have this arrow-like sign multiple times. If I had to draw this on a blank slide, let's see if I go to insert and shape, and let me see if I can get something similar. Oh yes, I have this chevron-like a shape. I'm going to click on that and click here. Correct. This is the same thing, same arrow that you get to see on the highways while you're driving. Now, if I keep Shift Control pressed and just drag it right, notice replicas being created fast, and they are all in the same line. In fact, if I choose all the four and then press Shift Control and then drag it down, notice how fast So it's significantly faster than Control C and Control V, and with the combination of other techniques like alignment, this will make sure that you get to prepare reports like these, and that too fast and accurate. In fact, let me spend some few extra seconds on showing you that this is also equally applicable for a text. So for example, let's say insert. I go to text box, I write my name, let's say Rishabh, and I'm going to follow this with, let's say, a hypothetical designation, let's say analyst in the debt capital markets. Okay, I'm just going to extend the width of this text box. Now notice this text box I'm choosing from the border, shift control down, shift control down, shift control down, and if I choose all four of them and then if I say shift control right, I'm able to make quick replicas. Taking one more new blank slide and putting a table element there, something like this, shift control down, I'm able to create two tables. Similarly, if I insert a new slide and I put a chart inside it, a basic, normal basic chart, let's say even this will do. Right, so I'm going to click on this Excel one and click it away. Let's say, let me just choose the chart and make sure it is small enough. And then when I press shift control, in fact, before pressing shift control, I'm holding the chart by the border. Right, shift control and then pulling it down. Ah, you came through a quick shock. It doesn't apply to chart, but what I can do with the chart is press control D and another replica got created. So maybe for chart, I might want to use control D, D for duplicate. So those are the various features you can use to make duplicates or clones of objects. Hope you liked it. And we'll see more of it in the case studies that follow sometime after. I hope you enjoyed our YouTube videos, and I really, really appreciate that if you could subscribe to our videos, which will also encourage me to give more such videos in the times to come. And you can also watch some of our popular programs which have been liked by a lot of viewers. See you soon.